Hello guys and welcome back. The topic for discussion for us in this video is the C preprocessor and command line arguments. So before moving on to actually the CPP, that is the C preprocessor, I'll discuss about command line arguments. Okay, now in this case I'll use a different editor, that's the Notepad++. In the earlier videos, as you must have seen, I've used Dev C++. Okay, so here I'll be using Notepad++. There's no difference at all. The only difference is that in this case we do not have an integrated compiler. If you want to compile it, you'll have to move to your command prompt and do it from there, the compilation and the execution part. Okay, so before we start off with the command line arguments, we obviously have to include the necessary header file, that is stdio.h, as usual. Now we write the main, that is void main, and inside this void main we will have two parameters, unlike what we have done till now. We haven't used anything inside the main, inside the parameters for main. So over here we'll have two parameters. Okay, let's make a counter and tell you what we are exactly doing. Okay, so for int, okay, for I equals 0, I less than argc I plus plus. The code will be quite evident. You must have understood basically what the thing is. Now let's say printf %s. I'll again tell you why I'm doing this. Let me just first write it, and this will be argv I. Okay, so over here what I'm doing is, see, inside main we have specified two parameters, that is argc and int argc and char star argv. Okay, so what is this argc? This argc basically stands for, argc stands for the argument counter, and argv stands for argument variable. Okay, now let's write it, argument var, or maybe let's say if just argument variable. So this argc basically counts the number of arguments that I'm passing using the command line, and argv stands for, argv keeps a count of, I mean, keeps track of whatever I'm passing through the command line. Okay, now in order to show you how it functions, what I've done is I've taken a loop counter or a loop variable, whatever, and I've initialized this with zero, and this loop will run as many times as the number of arguments over here that we have passed through the command line. Okay, so this is argc, and then I plus plus as usual. Okay, inside this what I've done is I've printed a string. One thing that you must note is that whatever you pass through the command line, that is taken as a string. Okay, and there is no concept of integers in this case. Okay, if you want to take it as an integer, you have to explicitly convert it into an integer and then use it. So by default, whatever we pass through the command line is in the form of a character array, as you must have understood here itself, because I have written a char star. Okay, and we are using an array over here because we may be passing multiple things or multiple values, multiple strings or multiple arguments through the command line. So in order to accept the multiple things that we are passing, we have to use it as a character array, and over here it's obviously a character array of character pointer basically. Okay, so and the customary thing that we are doing is, the inside the loop we are just printing out the value of whatever is stored inside argv, and we are printing that out using the array index. So let's go to the desktop and open the command line up here, open command window. Okay, not actually over here. Where do we have it? Let's see. I'll have to go to that location. I don't know where I have the code. Yeah. So inside this, what I'll do is I'll write gcc cmdl. That's the name of the file that I've written. cmdl.c. Let's see if we have got any error. There must not be any error actually. One thing that you must have noticed, what I did is, in case of command line, in this case, in case of Notepad++, instead of going and opening the folder which I was actually trying to do, what you can do is just right click over here, And after you right click, you can go into this option, that is open containing folder in CMD. So it will open the compiler basically. Okay, now let's run the code. It's a.exe. Let us say we are passing some values, maybe hello world. So there you go. So this is our command line. See, what's happening is I'm passing few values through the command line. The first value that I'm passing is a.exe. The second value that I'm passing is hello, and the third one is world. So over here, the values that we pass necessarily need to be space separated. So the first thing that is accepted is a.exe, as you can see over here. It's printing. It's getting printed over here. a.exe. That is argv0. Then we have this hello. The next value that's printed is hello. So this is argv1. And then we have got world. That is argv2. So whatever it is accepting or whatever it is printing, it is taking it with a space separated thing. Okay, the space is acting as the separator in this case. So that was it using command line. If you want to maybe pass some value, let's see if it works out. If you want to pass some integer over here, what you need to do is num is equal to a to i arg v1. Let us see if it works out and try printing it. So printf percentage d maybe slash n common num. Let's try and do this. So we have again gcc cmdl. What happened? Implicit declaration of a to oiuk. Most probably it is declared in, let's see, std lib. Let's see, one hello. So what's getting printed over here, let us see. Yeah, perfectly fine. See, what's happening over here is, probably you're not able to understand it. See, what we have done is we have passed three values over here using the command line, that is a.exe, which is obviously the name of the file that is getting executed. But even that one is, we are passing through the command line, so it's taking that one also as the argument, okay? Or the command line argument. After that, we have passed this one, then hello. So what's happening over here is, see, in this case, I've taken a num. That is, I've taken an integer variable, that's a num. So I've done num is equal to a to I. That means it is converting your argument to integer. A to I means argument to integer. So your argument over here is getting converted into integer using this function. And this is a function which has been defined inside stdlib.h. So whichever value I need to convert into an integer, I must obviously be knowing it. So inside this a to i, I've passed this parameter, that is argv1. Why? Because you must have noticed that I've passed the first argument, that is 0th, and then the first argument from the command line I've passed as an integer. So that's why I've taken over here num is equal to a2i argv. Now probably if I write a2i arg2, most probably it will show error. Why? Because in the second parameter I have written hello. Okay, now over there this number is getting printed. And once this is done, I'm obviously running this loop. So inside this loop, again, those three values are getting printed. That is a.exe, one, and hello. So that was how you use the command line arguments in C. So it's pretty simple. There's a few things that you need to keep in mind. Okay. Now we'll move on to understanding how the C preprocessor works. So over here, first of all, we have a C preprocessor. It is not part of compiler, but a separate step in the compilation process. Actually, the entire compilation process we have already discussed earlier in complete details. So over here, I will not go into the depth, but what I will say is, whatever preprocessors we define in the program, those get executed before the actual compilation of code is done. Okay. Next, we have all the preprocessors begin with a pound sign.
Pound sign means the hash. This is called the pound sign. Next, what we have is hash defined. This is a very important thing which we'll be using several times. So this hash defined creates an alias for the value specified using the directive. So this is a preprocessor directive. This hash define is a preprocessor directive. For example, when we write hash define max size 20, what happens is this max size creates an alias for this value, that is 20. So wherever you would have actually written this 20, 20, 20, there you can use max size. We shall see this, how to do it. Next we have, this is one important thing. Until now, what we have done is, in order to include header files, we have written hash include, say stdio.h or any header file.h. So what happens over here is, this header.h, writing it in this manner, actually includes the header file from the system libraries. This will tell the compiler that you go to the system library folder and check for this particular header file over there. But when you write it as hash include inside double quotes header.h, what happens is it tells the compiler that, okay, you don't need to go to the system libraries folder. You just check for this header file inside your local directory or the present working directory. So this will check for the header file in your current working directory.
So now let's take a look at macros. So over here, in order to save time, I've actually written down the entire different codes for macros. Now I'll just explain it to you how it works, because writing the same repetitive code again and again takes time. I have not kept the headache of, like writing the code now. I've written it. I'll explain it to you how it works. So first of all, let us open the CMD, open containing folder in CMD. Okay, now we're good to go. So over here, I've included two header files actually, although this one is not really needed. But the thing is, okay, we can comment it out, not a matter. So over here, what I've done is I've taken hash define size 5. Okay, so this size acts as my macro, and this size is nothing but it stores this value 5. So wherever I would have used 5 otherwise, I've used it as size. So say for I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So this line, this for loop is exactly same as this line. Over here, the only difference is that I've written size in place of 5. Why? Because I've already defined that 5 is nothing but it's this size. It's equivalent to the size. I've created an alias for 5. Okay. So wherever I would have mentioned 5 otherwise, I have mentioned size. Now, one thing you must have noticed that I have written the size in capital. Why it is so? Because so that it's basically easy to understand that we have defined a macro. Because otherwise we normally use size and such variables we normally use in the common programs, okay, common programs that we write. So that's why, just to distinguish it from the normal variables, I have written sizes and size in caps. So if I compile this code, we'll get the same output as we would have got if we did this. So let's compile this code, gcc macros.c. Let's see, it must be working. a.exe, exactly. So see, the output we have got very nicely. We have written iteration 0, iteration 1, iteration 2, iteration 3, iteration 4. So that is the output that we were expecting, and it's coming exactly the same. Now we move on to the next piece of code. So let's just comment out this one and this one. I'll uncomment this and this. So in this case, what I've done is I've taken a macro in this manner. That means I've defined a function as a macro. So in this case, you have to notice the syntax very nicely. See, over here, again, I've used this command line arguments. That's the reason why I had used stdlib, and the same I had put over here also, okay? Although we didn't use it over here. So in this case, I've written a function in the form of a macro. So the name of my function is square, okay? And inside that, I have one parameter, that is x. And what is the definition of this function? It's pretty simple. I have just written x into x. So whenever you will see that I have called this function square, it will basically, and along obviously with the parameters inside the square, you will see that this part will be executed in a similar fashion as this would be executed. So basically what I mean to say is that this statement is exactly same as this. There is no difference between this statement and this statement, just that we are using macro over here, macro definition of a function over here. Now sometimes using this kind of macro definition becomes very handy, because this piece of a code that I've written inside this, it's very very small. Okay, so if this gets pre-compiled, I've already discussed how the compilation process or the pre-processing takes place. So if this piece of code can be directly pre-compiled, then obviously the time overhead for the compiler to execute a particular code reduces. But had this code been very large, then that is not a very good option to use macro. In that case, we obviously have to use functions, because macro would just increase the overhead, because everywhere where the compiler encounters this square x or whatever the function is, okay, it would have to replace that same thing with this one, and the code would internally get unnecessarily elongated. So that makes no use. No, it's worthless. So over here, as because this definition is really small, I am using this one. So this increases this decreases the compile time. Now over here, I'm obviously passing a command line argument. That's why I have written int side is equal to atoi, that is a to I argv1. Okay. So if I compile this code, you'll see that gcc again macros.c and a.exe. Okay, what's wrong with this? Oh, obviously I did not pass anything. So a.exe say 5. So int side is equal to 5 and area is 25. So that is what we had expected. Now even if we just comment out this one and we write this, the output will be exactly the same. So let's put this inside comment. Now the next piece of code that I've written is this. Over here what I've done is, in this case I had passed the same values, that is x into x. In this case I'm passing two values. So this one I'm not taking the value as input from the user. Obviously you can take it. You'll need to do the same thing, int argc, argstar. I'll do that. Okay, I'll show it to you how. But in this case, I've just hard coded it. I've written mult 3, 2, this mult being the name of the macro that I've written. Inside this, I have this x, or it should be actually x, y probably. I don't know. Let's see. So if this is the case, I'm passing these two values and that value will be computed. Let us see if it works. GCC again, macros.c. Oops. So this was the problem. Anyways, GCC macros.c a.exe. So the value is 6. Sorry for that horrible problem that occurred. That was just because I was using this. Okay. Anyways, so the output was as expected. I am passing x comma y over here. I'm passing 3, 2 over here and accepting these two values inside x comma y, and the function for this macro function is computing the result for me. So it is basically the same as this one, no difference at all. Now what I'll do is I'll just comment this one out, and unlike the last time, I'll comment out only this line, and obviously I don't want to keep this. So in this case, what is happening is, hash define mult x and x comma y. In this case, it's very important to note. See, what's happening is 3 into 3, 2. So whenever I'm passing this, it will be x comma y. Whenever I'm passing this value over there, it is expecting, or it's taking it as 3 into 2. Obviously that is exactly what it must be taking, but the difference you'll be able to understand with the next piece of code that will illustrate. Okay, in this case the output will be as expected, that is 3 into 3 into 2 gives us probably 18. So that will be the output. Let's see a.exe. So the value is out, the output is 18. It's perfectly fine. But okay, instead of doing that, let's put a star here. But the difference comes over here when we do this. Let us put it inside comment. In this case, we must be expecting that the output will be a 6 into 2, that is 12, but that will not be the case. Instead, the output will be 9, because see, here I have written MULT 3 plus 3 comma 2. So this is basically a alias for MULT X. Again, it will be X comma Y. The same error has got basically copied out again and again from the top. But anyways, over here, this is basically acting as an alias for this thing. So whenever I call this macro definition, what is happening is it is getting replaced with, in this case, 3 plus 3, that is 3 plus 3 into 2. So my definition was X into Y. The value of X that I'm passing is 3 plus 3. So this is the value of X, 3 plus 3 over here, this one. This is my value of X. And after that, I'm passing the value of 2. And I've written X into 2. So X was basically 3 plus 3 and into 2. The compiler is not smart enough to be able to understand where you need to place a comma. It won't understand in what respect are you passing the values. You have to be a good programmer so as to insert a bracket over here. Exactly in the same fashion that I've done in the next piece of code. I'll show you that one also. So in this case, I'm obviously passing 3 plus 3, and then inside Y I'm passing this 2. So 3 plus 3 into 2 will give us, obviously, if you apply that BODMAS rule, the simplification rule, then you'll obviously get a value as 9. Okay, so that is what we will get. Well, let us see the output as well. That is GCC macros.c and a.exe. So the output is 9 as expected. Okay, now let's comment out this part of code again. And let's remove this. This is our next part, that is this one. So in this case, what I've done is I've tried to overcome this problem that was occurring. Here I've placed a bracket. I mean, I've placed X inside these brackets or inside this parenthesis. So over here, when I pass 3 plus 3 in the first parameter, what is essentially happening is it's coming out in this fashion. So over here, the first value of 3 plus 3 is getting computed. That comes out to be 6, and 6 multiplied by 2 comes out to be 12. So that is the output that we will get. Let us check. Okay. What happened? Yeah, again, that same mistake. It will be X comma Y. Let's clear it and compile. It will be GCC macros.c and a.exe. So the output is 12. That is as expected. So in all these cases, I have obviously hard-coded the values. I hope you have understood what I mean to say over here. The compiler, in this case, what it does is, in case of macro, it will just take this definition of yours and just replace this thing that you're passing. It will just replace this one with this definition. And whatever the value you have written, it will replace it with that. That means this line will basically change into, in this case, it will become 3 plus 3 into 2, because that is what you have written inside your definition. That is, whenever the compiler will encounter something of this format, that is mult whatever MULT X comma Y, if the compiler encounters anything of this format, it must just replace it with this. So that is what it's doing over here. The first parameter that you're passing is X, that is 3 plus 3. You're passing this one into X, and in the second one you're writing 2. So the compiler will just replace it over here. And similarly, in the above case as well, the compiler will just replace it as this. In this case, you have not written any brackets over there. That's why it will replace your piece of code in this fashion. So that's the very reason why you have got a 9 over here. Okay. So that was about macros. And after probably seeing the difference between this example After probably seeing the difference between this example and this last example, you must have clearly understood that you need to handle macros very well. Okay, you cannot just haphazardly write anything and expect the output to be perfectly fine. So that was all about macros, and also with this we come to the end of this video. So practice macros very, very nicely. That's what is said in each and every video. So thank you.